I'm excited. It's looking back now, it's hard to believe that those years have flown by. It seems like just yesterday I stepped on the yellow footprints. My mom was a Marine. She did 2 years back in the day, I want to say 1959. And my father was a retired captain. So it was always ingrained in me. I come from a long line of Marines. And I always knew that before I turned 27, or when I was 27, that was when I was going to enter. Well, to be perfectly honest, my father tried to persuade me to go into the Navy or Air Force where, you know, there were more females in those services. And my thought was, if Mom can do it and you did it, why not? I'm going into most elite forces. And he actually swore me in. He was my enlisting officer. I really enjoy what I do. This is one of the only jobs that you can work at a certain location for 3 to 5 years and then move somewhere else to a whole different location and do something incredibly different. You're never just pinpointed into doing the same thing day after day after day like so many other jobs in our civilian sector. And that really appealed to me. The next thing that appealed to me, of course, is the leadership has been hugely impactful. I've always wanted to be one of those leaders that you would want to follow. But I also wanted to make an impact on the Marine Corps. Something could be done better or could be improved upon. I wanted to be part of that team to help move forward in that direction. We're still the 911 of the United States, still ready to fight. I know they are changing the females' participation in combat roles. I think we've always been there. So that to me has not changed. But I'm glad that some of these doors are opening up, at least to provide people the opportunity. Because I do believe that there's a lot of female Marines out there that are capable of doing these jobs that require a little more strength. But I don't think it's for all female Marines. So my hat's off to all those who are putting their names in the hat, and they're going to break more ground for those who will come after them. We'll tell you, the basic school was a treat. They handed me a broom and showed me where the coffee pot was, told me I was going to be the scribe because females don't operate. And I told the staff sergeant that I thought that was a little messed up, but overall, I guess I'm the winner. There are going to be naysayers out there and people who don't necessarily agree with females being in the Marine Corps, but again, we have as much right to be here as anyone. Just do your job, learn as much as you can, and become good at what you're doing. And pick those qualities out of those leaders that you really like and leave the rest behind. You learn in boot camp, knowledge is power. Learn everything you can and follow your orders and speak up, even though it's not the popular thing to do. Choose your battles. Not every fight's worth fighting. Stand your ground, draw your boundaries, and stick to them. It wasn't in my crosshairs that this was a goal of mine. And so I think by obtaining this rank, I think that others will hopefully have it set as a goal and strive to meet that.